Tanya Johnson's experiential objective is to develop a strong mentor relationship to guide her doctoral work and career goals, including research and dissertation, as well as work-life balance in the context of her cultural background. Her impact objective is to develop a series of professional development workshops to effectively increase multicultural competence among fellow counselors that can be delivered in person or online. She was raised in Salt Lake City, Utah, as a devout member of the Mormon Church by a white father and Cuban immigrant mother. Her culture discouraged women to become educated past undergraduate degrees or to pursue careers. When she applied for the fellowship, she had been working in inpatient psychiatric ward for a few years and had started her PhD at Barrett University in Miami. She loved serving the diverse community in South Florida and advocating for the people with severe and persistent mental illness who she served. Receiving the fellowship was a big shock. She had applied with a shot-in-the-dark attitude. She recalls sitting with the group and wondering if her application had been mixed up, feeling the imposter syndrome. Her only mentor before this fellowship has been her mother, who always encouraged her to be an individual in a very conformist culture. She immigrated from Cuba at 16, was homeless in Spain for some months, held back in high school while she learned English, then put herself through college by working night shifts as a bookkeeper. Through the MFP fellowship, she has had the opportunity to create new mentoring relationships with Barry faculty and NBCC leaders, which have helped her to clarify her academic and career goals. The experience of being encouraged to participate in conferences, publish and present her ideas, and contribute to the field in meaningful ways is a brand new experience for her. With the monetary support of the program, she was able to start a private practice to serve diverse clients with mental illness and faith crisis issues. She also became a distance certified counselor in order to expand her practice to those who live too far away from her office or who are disabled. Her clients include a wide range of ages, ethnic backgrounds, religious backgrounds, mental illness, and geographic locations. She plans to partner with other counselors interested in practicing using technology and serve populations in need of specialized counseling. She presented with her cohort and two professors at her state counseling conference on a narrative intervention definitional ceremonies. It was her first conference and first presentation. Another shot-in-the-dark application she submitted was to NBCC International's Tango Institute to Buenos Aires. She was accepted and traveled with a group of counseling professionals and leaders such as David Fennell, Scott Hinkle, and Ted Rimley. She also met one of her new MFP fellows there. Meeting counseling professionals in another country was a valuable multicultural experience on a personal and professional level. Learning a systemic model of substance abuse counseling at a free community clinic revived her energy in working with this population. At the beginning of this year, she took the position of clinical services manager at Barry's on-campus teaching clinic. She manages the daily operations of the clinic and assists with the practicum and internship programs. After meeting the MFP cohort last year and realizing that everyone gets it in terms of multicultural issues, she began wondering how to more effectively teach counseling students how to get it if they don't happen to have life experiences that teach them about cultural differences. She began researching the literature on counselor education and on multicultural issues and saw that most of the literature was written by and aimed toward white counselors to help them understand minority clients. There is no literature regarding diverse counselors and their multicultural competence. For this reason, she chose to build her group based on Finney's ethnic identity model, which is culture non-specific. She conducted a series of six groups with a master's level multicultural issues class at Barry University, which is a group of diverse, mostly multi-ethnic students. She used experiential activities and discussions to foster ethnic identity development in each individual student. She used Finney's multi-ethnic identity measure as a pre and post assessment with her group to measure change. There was some measurable change, and almost all of the students expressed they felt more comfortable in their own sense of ethnic identity due to the safe space created in the group. She used exercises such as this one to expand the idea of multicultural issues beyond ethnicity to include gender issues, ableism, religion, class, etc. Students appreciated increasing their awareness of multiple layers of identity. In March, she was able to attend the ACA conference in Honolulu and shared a room with her fellow MFPs, Ophelia and Tiffany. The social and professional connections in the program have been invaluable. Thanks to meeting Scott Hinkle in Argentina, she was able to join the editorial board for The Professional Counselor and has started reviewing manuscripts. Her fellowship year has been more significant and life-changing than she could have imagined. A year ago, she felt out of place, and with the support of mentors, she has come into her own as a professional and clarified her academic direction.